All right, howdy folks, Kevin Lacey here, and today we're going to ride along in this little Diamond DA62. I'm with Trevor Mustard from Canada over there, and he's going to be doing us a demo flight. We're also going to be doing a photo shoot for Plane and Pilot magazine here. We got Doug Jeans and Scott Slocum going to join up with us on a Bonanza. This ought to be a pretty exciting flight, but in the meantime, just a brandy spanking new Diamond 62 airplane. Look at all the fancy whiz-bang dials and gauges and gadgets in here. By the way, we got 180 horsepower turbocharged diesel engines on the side out here. This airplane is fully composite. If you wanted to order yourself one today, you're going to look 6 to 9 months of delivery time, because these airplanes, if you want a special paint color, this color is blended into the weave of the carbon fiber, whatever it is on this airplane's made of. Anyway, it's designed to be a 7-passenger airplane. It's pretty sporty. We're going to take you along for a ride and give you an idea what it's all about. So hang on, we're going for a ride.
You're going to feel a stutter when you jump to the next one, and that's intentionally built in so you know which computer you're running on and which one is on the redundant safety backup. Yeah, I feel that little stutter.
Right.
So that tells me right away that we're operating on ECU-A and by backup computer.
Okay.
All right, here comes the run-up. It's simply hold this. We'll watch it go through its cycle. Engines will run up. They'll cycle the props. They'll come back down. It'll switch over to the redundant computer. Do the same thing over again. Enunciators are out. I'll do the same thing over here. So I'll just check A and B. So actually the backup on this one in this case. So we'll do the same thing on the right engine.
Oh, so right. Good grief. This thing, you don't do a mag check, don't cycle the props. You push a button and the airplane does it all for you.
It's all looked after by the computer system.
Oh my goodness.
That's it. Anuns are out. That's it. The run-up is complete.
Oh, good grief there, boys and girls. Old school's learning something new here. How you like that?
Yeah, here we go. Fuel pump's on. Engine master's on. Gear is down. There's a gear warning horn for us. Pumps. Trim is set. We will use one notch flap for departure on this airplane.
Okay.
And Mike Romeo, you can change the tower 126.
126 nothing for departure.
126 nothing. Brakes off.
Okay, boys and girls, we've been cleared for takeoff, and we're going to see how old Trevor handles this. Oh, look at the runway pop up on the screen over there. Engines all dialed in, computer controlled, of course. You only got one lever to operate with, and airspeed is
positive rate. Gear up.
Gear coming up. Just keep on going a little further. Oh, I can feel the slipperiness come into it.
Yeah.
Fox. All right, there you go.
On this Fox VFR.
You can turn now.
Fox VFR, Fox Golf Zulu.
Acceleration was pretty good going down the runway. It's smooth, and those diesel engines aren't blowing Black City smoke out of them like I expected them to. What's up with that, Trevor?
We burn them clean here, buddy.
Oh, they're using that clean diesel there, huh? That must be some of that bio-willy fuel that I heard.
Turn left heading 05.
So, anyway, that's pretty cool. And I'm looking for our Bonanza, and I'll let you know when I see them.
Foxtrot Golf Zulu, flight of 2, the one behind. Reset transponder, Squawk VFR.
Squawk 1200.
We're squawking 1200 there now for Fox Golf Zulu.
Roger.
Go that way.
Need to come right, Diamond 1. heading 230.
Dialing this in with a photo ship, just to see how that works. Here you go.
On the airplane and forward, and see if you can see where the hole is in the floor.
Here we are, folks. So, getting.
Okay, what I want you to do now is pull forward to where I'm kind of shooting down the side of the airplane. So come forward 20 and up 5.
20 and up 5. Here we are, boys and girls. We're in the middle of a photo shoot for Plane of Pilot magazine. We got Doug Jeans up there along with Scott Slocum on the camera. We got
check gear.
Well, that engine shuts down quick, doesn't it?
Good. Oh, yeah. Start her back up.
Well, in case nobody knows what's going on, I'm hiding the camera from the camera ship up there. But we are doing videos. We just did complete engine shutdown and feather of the prop. And we're now doing some other videos coming
forward 20.
We're doing belly shots out of the belly of the airplane. So I'm keeping the camera down low. I tried to get you a shot of the shutdown engine there. Seems like the old airplane didn't even hesitate. Shut down, it stops immediately. When it starts up, it starts
through the middle of the airplane now. So center up on the plane and keep coming forward.
I'll give you a shot of the photo bird. There you go. That's all you get. All right, boys and girls. Hey, that was an awesome photo shot, photo flight there with Doug and Scott. Now, what do you think, Trevor? Was that pretty good?
That's something else. That's a real workout, I'll tell you.
Hey, you look like you were working pretty hard. I mean, that doggone just maneuvering real close to another airplane, getting in and out of the way. Was pretty cool, but you did a great job on that.
Thanks, Jeff.
Yeah, you ought to be proud of that. That was quite a lot of fun. But anyway, now as you can tell, that's my hand on the controls, and I'm not sure what I'm doing with it just yet. But we're gonna mosey around out to the east just a little bit, and then we're gonna head on back into Addison. Make sure Trevor gets his adult beverage that he so deserves by now. So I'll check back in a few minutes. Does it ever bother you flying around in an airplane that's got a computer control and everything?
No, not one bit.
Not one bit, huh?
No, I certainly appreciate all the redundant backups in this airplane, I'll tell you. Yeah, it's a magnificent airplane as far as safety goes.
Well, how many years have you been flying?
Just coming up on 20 years as a licensed pilot, but I've been around general aviation my whole life.
Okay, well, I'm just kind of curious because, you know, old school guys like me, you know, there's a round dial over there. We know it's going to, that's pretty decent, pretty reliable. But, you know, how many emergency backup batteries do you think this airplane has?
You know what?
For all these TV screens and tubes, there's got to be, you know, for certification purposes.
I couldn't even tell you how many pounds of extra battery weight we're carrying around in this airplane right now, but we've got redundancy upon redundancy in this thing.
Not to mention the ones that are operating our headsets, too.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, by the way, thank you. You got a good choice of headsets there with those Bose there, you know. Thank you, Bose. These things work great, you know.
They're fantastic.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're moseying our way back towards Addison, kind of going to go a long way around a little bit, going to do a drive by the home plate there, Aero Country, and then head on over there to, head on back over to Addison.
Indicating about 170. Oh, that's certainly a lot higher than you'd usually be set for power in a situation like this, but even pushed all the way up to nearly max continuous, we're still burning less than 10 gallons an hour per side. So with that being said, I'll bring it back to about 70% power and kind of get ready for a speed that's more appropriate for entering this circuit. And already you can see we're back down to 6.9 gallons per hour.
I can tell you this much. This is a pretty spiffy little airplane. It's it's got some unique characteristics and qualities. The only thing I have a problem with is there's not much visibility out the front there.
Yeah, it does lack a little bit of visibility compared to the DA-42 in that respect, but otherwise the visibility out the sides is certainly nice.
Yeah, oh yeah, it is, without a doubt. We're going to sign off now while we deal with the controllers over here at Addison Airport. Y'all.
All right, take care, everybody.
Look at that. Yeah, he knows where we're at. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a DA-62, brandy spanking new from Austria. If nothing else, it's pretty sexy, isn't it?